My foundation is that of a graffiti artist mm-hmm. in the 70s and 80s, but it's progressed into Gothic Futurism.
Right.
You know, I mean, I studied under Ramelzi and Donnie. Those were my teachers, Donnie White, CIA crew, mm-hmm. and in Brooklyn, TC5 crew, and up in the Bronx. But I mean, I don't really put a label on it now. I mean, people put all kinds of labels on things, but I mean, I just basically paint to express my my need to express, man. I mean, it's just like based upon dreams, the occult, the surreal, experiences as a b-boy mm-hmm. in New York, coming from New York, you know. Been through a lot of, I'm 43 years old, so I've seen a lot in New York, and that is translated through a lot of my work, sacred geometry and mathematics, you know, mapomatics.
For upcoming artists that are trying to break into the scene, that are trying to do something with their lives, that are trying to find some meaning, you know, some validation, what sort of advice would you give to upcoming artists?
Just to follow your own voice and not to really, not to copy or to carbon copy a style that's popular or, you know, don't become a carbon copy of like what's happening. The happening happens and it's already happened. If you're in it for girls, you're in the wrong profession. If you're in it for like notoriety, you're definitely in it for the wrong reasons. True artist actually just does it because he has to, not because he wants prestige or all these things. I've been blessed. I've been lucky enough to have landed the role of whatever Grand Poobah. But it's you know, I mean, I'll paint regardless of all the shows and all the notoriety. I mean, really stay true to your voice, you know? And don't be afraid. That's the thing. Fear really keeps people from expressing themselves. So, I mean, like, really just be fearless. Be the warrior. Just knock it out, son. That's it.